It's like, Demo, I'm sorry, your name escaped me. I'm sorry, your name escaped me.
很抱歉，我忘记您的名字了。
They tried to escape death. They tried to escape death.
他们设法逃脱了死亡。
Okay, next word, slam.
这是一个逆声的动词，砰的关上。
Slam the door.
砰的关上门。它的同义词 bang,
B-A-N-G. He left the room, slamming the door behind him.
Or, he left the room, banging the door behind him. 他离开了房间，在身后砰的把门关上了。
I should say the vocabulary in lesson 13 is very easy for us.
Now let's get on to the text.
After her husband had gone to work, Mrs. Richards sent her children to school and went upstairs to her bedroom. So we know her husband was at work and her children were at school. She was at home alone.So she went upstairs to her bedroom.
她的丈夫在上班，孩子们上学去了，她一人在家，所以走上楼去到了卧室。
She was too excited to do any housework that morning. Too excited to do any housework that morning. According to this sentence, particularly the key structure, to.She was so excited that she couldn't do any housework that morning.
根据句型结构 to, 同学们清楚，它表示太什么而不能。我们在应用这个结构的时候，不定式 to 在大部分情况下所表达的概念都是一个否定的概念。
We learned the key structure in book one.
在一册就已经接触过这个句型。
Your question is too difficult for me to answer.
但如若我们把 to 句型用于否定句式
，not to, never to,
其所表达的概念表示并不太怎么样，所以能够。
I think you are familiar with the proverb, one is never too old to learn.
大家对这个谚语应该很熟悉。
One is never too old to learn.
活到老，学到老。
For another example, the question is not too difficult for me to answer.
这个问题不难，所以我能答得出。如果同学们在副词 to 之前发现了修饰语
all,
but, only,
那么不定式 to 的概念也是肯定的。
请同学们注意
all, but, only.
For example,
they are all too satisfied to work with you.
他们都非常的满意，很想和你在一起工作。
They are all too satisfied to work with you.
For another example,
I'm only too glad to have someone to speak to. I'm only too glad to have someone to speak to.
我太高兴了，想找个人说说话。
He was but too eager to get home.
他太急于要回家了。
Okay, now, let's go on with our text. So move back to line 3. She was too excited to do any housework that morning. Why? For in the evening...She would be going to a fancy dress party with her husband. Fancy dress party,
you know, costume party. 因为她要和丈夫一起去参加化妆舞会。 She intended to dress up as a ghost. Intend to
means mean to.
有什么打算意图。Dress up as a ghost. Dress up as, 化妆成为一鬼。And as she had made her costume the night before,
她已经前一个晚上就把这个化妆服准备好了。
对 ,the night before, 前一个晚上，它是以过去的某个时间为基准点。如果我们想表达昨天晚上，以现在为基准点 ,last night.
For example,
She went to New York on business the night before. She got everything ready. She went to New York on business 3 days ago.
三天前她去纽约出差。
The night before,
在去之前的一个晚上
She got everything ready. 她把一切都准备好了。She was impatient to try it on.She was impatient, you know. She was eager to try it on. She was anxious to try it on. Be patient, you know. Be impatient to do something.
急于要做某事，迫不及待了。所以我们可以替换为 eager,
anxious, 甚至可以用 hungry, thirsty,
For example, 我急于要见到你。
I'm eager to see you. I'm impatient to see you. I'm anxious to see you. I'm hungry to study English.
我们太渴望学习英语了。
Or I'm thirsty to study English.
如果所表达的概念更强烈的话，我们不妨用 desperate.
D-E-S-P-E-R-A-T-E.She is desperate to get the news.
她太急于得知这个消息了。那么在口语当中，我们不妨用 can't wait. 我等不及了，非见你不可。
I can't wait to see you.
So we know,
Mrs. Richards couldn't wait to try it on because she wanted to know whether her costume was.Alright or not. Because she wanted to know whether the costume fit her.
她想知道这个化妆服是不是合身。
Try on,
试穿。
No, the costume consisted only of a sheet.
虽然这个化妆服只是一个大被单所组成的。
It was very effective.
那么效果呢却很好。
Let's say, when she put it on,She looked like a ghost. After putting it on,
putting, 动名词和介词 after 搭配连用，穿上以后
Mrs. Richards went downstairs. She wanted to find out whether it would be comfortable to wear. She wanted to discover whether the costume would be comfortable to wear.
因为她想弄清楚这个化妆服穿起来是否舒服。
动词不定式 to wear
用来修饰说明 comfortable 做它的状语
For example
这本书读起来很难
The book is difficult to read
这条裙子很好洗的
The dress is easy to wash
你的字很容易辨认
Your handwriting is easy to recognize
不定式经常用于形容词之后那么这种表达概念不定式主要是做状语
OK
有的同学可能要提出一个问题为什么说这个衣服穿起来是否舒服应该是衣服被穿呢为什么要采用主动语态结构呢而没有采用被动呢同学们知道
在 It would be comfortable to wearComfortable to wear 之间省略掉了一个介词短语 It would be comfortable for her to wear
对于我来讲这本书读起来很简单
It is easy for me to read. Are you quite sure about that?
那么在英文当中，不乏主动形式，但是表达的是被动概念。